Hi, I'm O'Shane, one of the supervisors here at Dennis Shipping. We have been in operation for over 30 years here on this site for more than 20 years at 1124 Utica Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. And as you know, we have another location over in the Bronx and another one in Florida, New York. I'll take you on a little journey of a typical day here in the life of Dennis Shipping. Everything pretty much starts here, where customers will either walk in or they'll call on the phone. 90% of the business happens on the phone, and this is the whole operation here where we have our customer service representatives. They take our calls, they handle the walk-ins. Customers can either schedule pickups, they can come in, drop off their cargo, they can purchase supplies for packing, and you know, they are also, while taking calls, doing paperwork for manifesting, scheduling their drop and picks, and doing the whole work. So when a customer comes in to pack on site, they'll first come to one of our reps. They will take the information from them, their name, their address, their phone number, who they're shipping it to, what country they're shipping it to, and then they'll send them on the outside where they will start the packing process. So come on outside. Right now we have a customer who has started the packing process. She is doing a barrel. She has purchased one of the barrels here. We store them on the side here. We don't have the nice facility as the folks down in Florida do, but here we are, we make it work. Our customers, they come in and they do what they have to do. We sell various size barrels, and these are the largest we sell, the 77-gallon fiber barrels. We call them the Super Jumbo. And we sell the plastic ones as well. If you come this way, we have the small ones, which are 58 gallons. We have the large ones, which are also 77 gallons. Customers may also opt to get boxes. We sell those here too, and we have them on display, and the various sizes based on what they are going to be packing, they'll choose one and they'll get the process started. Customers may also ask us to deliver these supplies to them, and they call us on the phone. We schedule a pickup. We will send the drivers with them, drop them off. A day or two later, they call us back. We go, we pick up the items, and we bring them to the warehouse. Once we bring them to the warehouse, we then begin the sorting process. So I'll take you on the other side where that all happens. Once our drivers, they come in with all the barrels and boxes and cargo, each day they start early mornings, they offload their cargo right underneath the shed here. Basically, what we do, we sort the cargo based on the port. Now, if you look closely, you'll see that some barrels have different color tapes on them, and that will indicate what country they will go to. We have ones with the brown tape. Those are going to Kingston, Jamaica. Those with the blue tape, these are going to Montego Bay, Jamaica, and then all the other color tapes, the oranges, the greens, the reds, the purple, those go to the other islands in the Caribbean. And as you know, we ship just about to every island out there. We have agents who receive cargo and distribute paperwork to the customers on the receiving end. So once the cargo gets offloaded in our warehouse here, we sort them into different sections based on the port. So right now we have everything sorted here for Kingston. They've already moved the items that were here for Montego Bay. They've already loaded that in a container. And over this side, you'll see various colors as well lining up. Those are gonna go to all the other islands. Now, once that is sorted, my warehouse team, right now we have Julian over here. He's doing the tallying process. And all he's doing, he is writing up all the barrels, you know, the customer, what they're shipping. And once he's done with that process, then another team, right now we have Barrett on the forklift. He's gonna take each of those items that are already tallied, ready to go. And once they're tallied, we have them marked and they'll get loaded into a container. So for Jamaica, these containers were just dropped a while ago. The trucker is actually still here. So it's right now it's empty, but we will put all the Kingston cargo inside one of these containers. This one is predominantly for Kingston. And then we have the Montego Bay container. The trucker is actually now picking this one up. Once the container is full, we seal it. Add the seal on there as a security feature. And that seal is not broken until it gets to the destination. In this case, it's gonna go to Montego Bay, and they will remove the seal, check the markings on there, make sure it matches up, nobody tampered with it, and it's good to go. Unlike for the Jamaica shipments, which gets loaded in a container here, we have to actually assemble all the barrels and boxes, appliances, furniture. For the other ports, after tallying them, we will stack them here. We'll schedule a trailer coming that will pick this up, take it all the way to Florida, and that's where they load the cargo and have it shipped out to the various destinations. And that's what makes our movements, our shipments out of New York so much faster. Versus loading a full container for each port, we're able to take these to Florida where it is consolidated and loaded with other shipments out of Florida, and it goes there much faster. That's pretty much a day in the life of Dennis Shipping in a quick nutshell.